Hey guys, I'm Janice and you're watching Sharp Cookie. Today I'm going to teach you how to do mental math for percents. Now, why is this helpful? Well, this is one of those skills that I actually use a lot. I know there's some areas of math, maybe trig and advanced algebra, that we really don't use every day. But honestly, percents is something that I use all the time, and it's really helpful when you can just do it quickly in your head. So let me give you some examples. You're out shopping, there's a discount, and you want to know about how much you would get off on a sale item. Or you go to the cash register and you kind of want to know what your sales tax is going to be, especially for those higher priced items where you know it'll be significant. And another example is tipping. If you live in the US like I do, you know that we run into tipping all the time. You go to a restaurant, you go to a massage therapist, you get your hair cut. It's really common in the US to have to tip people. So these are three common areas, and I'm gonna teach you how to quickly do percents for all three of these so that you don't have to get out your calculator, you don't have to be punching in numbers into your phone, you can just do it quickly in your head. Okay, so my first example, you're out shopping, there's a sale item, how do you figure out what it is? Okay, let's do it. So the first thing I always do is I figure out what 10% would be. My whole mental math system with percents is based on 10%. So figure out what 10% is first. Now you're thinking, well, I don't know how to do that. Yes, you do. You move the decimal place over one spot because 10% is the same thing as dividing any number by 10. And we learned in middle school, wherever you learn that, that dividing something by 10 is the same thing as moving the decimal place one spot over. So some quick examples. What's 10% of 300? 30. What's 10% of 247? 24.7. What's 10% of 100? 10. What's 10% of 70? 7. There you go. Really simple. So now you know how to find 10% of any number. But let's say your sale item is 20% off. What do you do? Well, we just figured out how to do 10%. So if it's 20%, it has to be times 2 or double that number. So if you can find 20%, just find the 10% first and then double it. The same works for 30%. If you want to find 30% of a number, instead of doubling it, we have to triple it or multiply it by 3. So let's run through some examples. What if I want to find 40% of 70? Now, 10 minutes ago, you'd probably be thinking 40% of 70. There is no way I can do that. Well, you can. It's really simple. You find 10% first and you multiply by 4. So 10% of 70 is 7. 7 times 4 is 28. There you go. 40% of 70 is 28. You can do it. So that's the easiest way to figure out sales on items. Now, again, this is all based on a 10 system. Maybe the sale is 22% off or the thing you want to buy is $63. I always just round to the nearest 10. Unless you need a really precise number, go ahead, get out your calculator. But most of the time in my everyday life, I never need to know exactly down to the penny what I'm going to pay at the cash register. I just want a general idea. So for what we're doing, just rounding to 10. So if the item is $62, just round it to 60. Everything is a lot easier that way. If it's right in the middle, then round up or down a little bit, and you know at the end, whatever that sale is gonna be, just a little bit more or less, and it's good enough. Okay, now another example. You're at a restaurant, you need to pay a tip for somebody, okay? So in the US, our tips run 10% on the very, very low end if the service was awful, or 20% typically on the high end if the service was just awesome. So now you know how to figure out 10%, right? So if your bill is around $40, I can quickly know, okay, 10%, $4. 20% double that, $8. So my tip should be somewhere in the range of 4 to 8. If it was exactly average service, which is typical in the US where we tip 15%, that would be around $6. So if I'm going to a restaurant, I know right away if it's a $40 bill, I'm going to be paying $6 for the tip. Again, if the bill was $42, well, add on another 50 cents. You don't have to be super precise about it. Just sort of round up a little bit if you know your bill was a little more than $40. So that's the easy way that I do tipping at restaurants. Okay, last thing is sales tax. Now, I know if you're lucky and you live in somewhere like Delaware, so great, you don't have to worry about this. Or we could all just move to Delaware. But if you like where you live and you don't want to move, you probably have a sales tax. Now, here in San Diego, the sales tax is over 8%. So what I typically do is I just figure out 10%. And then I round down a little bit. So I'll give you an example. Last week, I needed to buy a camera. The camera was $600, and I knew this was a big purchase, and I kind of wanted an idea of what I would be spending in total after tax. So if the camera's $600, then your 10% would be 60. Now, again, San Diego isn't 10% like it is in maybe New York City or somewhere like that. So I know it's going to be a little bit less, but not a lot less. So I estimated it at $50. Now, when I did eventually get to the checkout, it was almost very, very close to $50. So it gave me a good idea that, hey, this camera isn't actually going to cost 60, it's going to cost me 650. Now, what if you live in another place where you do have sales tax, but it's not close to 10%? Let's say it's closer to 5%. So if you want to figure out 5%, you figure out 10% and you divide it by 2. So that same camera somewhere else where the sales tax is less, let's say around 5% sales tax, instead of $60 or $50, I would divide 60 by 2 and get $30. So if your sales tax is 5%, you're going to spend $30 on taxes at the cash register. Now, again, this is rounding. So let's say your sales tax is 6%. Well, then bump it up a little. You're probably going to spend somewhere between $30 and $40. If it's 4%, you're going to spend a little bit less, so let's say around $25. And you get a really good sense of what you're going to be spending. And you get to use your brain. Like, who doesn't want to work their brain? Especially as we get older and we use our brains less and less and rely on our phones more and more. I even see my students do this all the time. They can't do anything without their phone. How great would it be if we could work our brains in our everyday life and not have to use our phones? So those are the tips I have for today. If you found this video really helpful, which I hope you did, please, I thank you in advance. Give it a thumbs up. It really helps other people find this video, find this channel, and get more tips. If you enjoyed my content, also think about subscribing. I'm going to be coming out with new videos every week to help you. So that's all I have for today. Hope you enjoyed it. Have an awesome day. I'm Janice. This is Sharp Cookie.